To know me is to ride with me, or something like that. Have you ever gotten on your bike and not felt like the baddest dude on the road? It's okay. It happens to all of us. Today, I'm gonna help you fix that. Today, you're gonna learn how to take your Softail to the next level. Today, you're gonna start building a Cholo. Because every time I ride my Cholo, I know I'm the baddest motherfucker on the streets.
Welcome back to J.E.T. Film. I'm John, and today we're going to cover every single part that I put on this Cholo Softail. This is an updated video. Last year, I did a parts video, but the bike was nowhere near where it is today, and a lot of those parts were actually changed out. We're going to cover from top to bottom and front to back, so if there's something you dig about the bike that you don't know what it was or where I got it, chances are I'm going to cover it, and now you'll know. All right, so let's start with the grips. These are Accutronics brass grips. They have a few different styles, but I guarantee if you type in Accutronics brass grips in Google, you're probably gonna find these right away. All right, you're looking at 130 bucks-ish. Like I said, a few different styles. This one I thought was the most dynamic. So the controls are actually by Vitti's Design, which is a company in Italy that I just happened to stumble across one day doing some research. Their controls, I ended up getting brass levers with polished kind of everything else. The brass brake fluid reservoir I thought looked so awesome. Now this is polished brass. Everything lines up just right. Everything works so well. Also, I found their mirrors. These are also by Vitti's Design, polished arm, and then the brass backing to the mirror. These are 3-inch mirrors, and I love 3-inch mirrors for Harleys. They're kind of worthless, but that's not really their fault. This is the fault of the configuration that I have the bike in, especially with the tall bars leaning forward. There's only so much angle you can put these mirrors at. So I generally find myself going like this to look behind me, or I just go like that. It's just the sacrifice you're gonna have to make if you wanna ride a Cholo. All right, so next is the Apes. These are 16-inch Carlini Gangsters, 1.25-inch thick, non-stepped. I get compliments on these bars all the time, and everybody always asks me on the internet how tall I am. So I'll just tell you now, I'm 5'10 and a half, if you want to get technical. So yeah, that's 16-inch on 2-inch risers, and I personally think it's the perfect look. Any more, and I would be like this, and my arms would probably get really tired. This, it's above my shoulder, just slightly, you know, combining with other things like your seat and your suspension. It gives me the perfect amount of arched back just to get that really gangster look. All All right, so next is the cables. These are Magnum Shielding Sterling Chromite Braided Cables. I got them in a kit. If you go to magnumshielding.com, you type in your bike year and size of your new bars, it'll automatically give you a list of kits, different colors and whatever, that will fit your bike. Now, they will charge you an arm and a leg for them, but they do look great, they hold up, they're anti-UV fading, whatnot. They've been great to me. They also come with the wiring extension kit, and so you just extend your wires and that's it. It takes the guesswork out. So these cable holders, right? I actually don't even know the brand. They might be Drag Specialties, but I think they're just like a no-name brand. I got them on eBay. Let me do two on each side, and technically on your clutch side, you really don't need two, but just to kind of make it more symmetrical, I put two over here. I mean, $15 a piece, and there's four of them. Actually, technically, I have six of them because I have two down here, but it's expensive. But you know what? The whole Cholo game's expensive, so get ready. All right, so next are the risers. These are Carlini 2-inch risers. They've changed the name of, I think, this exact model. So now I think they're called El Presidente. Don't quote me on that, but they have a very distinct look. So if you go to Carlini's website, you'll definitely find them within just a minute. They've been great. I thought, you know, no better risers to get than Carlini's own risers. So if you have Carlini bars, Carlini risers, and I'm glad I did because they never slip. I've never had a problem with them. They look super clean, and I do have a chip on one of them, which drives me nuts. Not sure how I got that there. I must have dropped like a wrench on it or something, but that would be the only thing, and that's not Carlini's fault. All right, so next are the fork tube top caps. These are also by Vitti's Design. They were expensive, but they do look great as a nice little accent piece. I'm glad I got them. Haven't had an issue with them. Okay, so for the lights, my triple headlight system, light internals are actually by Advan Black. I got them last September. They've been great. They were cheaper than the Harley system or a lot of other systems. And once I got those, it set it off with the rest of the bike. Let me get LEDs for the whole bike. So I did, especially with the turn signals, those I got off eBay. They're kind of just like a plug-in and just drop-in. Same goes for the rear turn signals, and then the rear tail light is just I think it's 1157 or 1156 LED bulb that I just screwed in. So the light visors I got from Utah Harley. Turn signal visors I did get on eBay. They work great. I did have a couple small issues with them not fitting very snug with the first batch. And then I just ordered a couple more. They're very cheap. And then ended up being a nice snug fit. It's probably just a quality control thing, but they're just so cheap that you can just keep ordering them until they get it right. All right, moving down, upper fork slider covers. I got rid of the stainless steel ones that come with the bike. Then I went to chrome ones, normal size. Then I went to chrome 2-inch over, which were great, they're still great. And then I wanted to see what they would look like if I went back to the normal. I don't know really, I had some elaborate plan, I won't get into it. Now I'm gonna change them again in the next couple weeks, but I'll leave that for later. These are I believe they're Drag Specialties. They are a pain in the ass to put in because you have to basically remove the whole front end. But once they're in and they're pretty much good forever. Also, the Drag Specialties one, I mean, they're very plain. They're just chrome, there's no design to it, which is fine. You know, it depends on what you want. And then if you do have any fitment issues, like it's touching your fender, the great thing is they're actually pretty damn thin where you can literally compress them a little bit to make them instead of like a perfect circle. Now they're more of like a little bit on the oval side. That way it doesn't have a fitment issue. That's just like a little trade secret Okay, so fork lowers. These I've already changed, what, twice? I had the stock ones, then I had chrome ones, and now I have these dope black ones, which I got through this exchange program on eBay. You send them your originals, then they send you back these ones that are powder coated in black or chrome or whatever you want, and then they remove the core charge. So I think they were like 170 bucks. Personally, I think it's really worth it because they guarantee them that they're in perfect shape. They're just originals with powder coat on them. So for you guys that really preferred the chrome look rather than the black, I'll tell you why I went with the black. And that was basically just to match up the rear swing arm with the fork lower, so anything that's holding the wheels is now in black. Brakes. Calipers are actually stock. They're just painted with G2 caliper paints. High heat paint, haven't had an issue. That stuff is really good. You get really good results as long as you do your prep work, which really wasn't even that much. I just thought that the stock calipers, that wrinkled black, it just looked really aged and just terrible. So I wanted more of a glossy black look. And then with the white paint pen, I went over that kidney bean looking thing. And it just made them pop. All right, so the brake rotors are by Lindell Brakes. I'm also using Lindell Gold Plus brake pads too, because if you haven't noticed yet, these brake rotors are gold. It's not real gold. It's gold color impregnated metal. However the heck they do it, I don't know, which is probably why they charge so much for these things. I did have a problem with my first pair, but Lindell made good on it, so I sent them back. They sent me back a brand new pair, and it's done with. The handlebar bag, all right? It's just a cheapo bag. I got it for like 15 bucks on eBay, so don't think that I spent hundreds of dollars. It's not really even leather. It's probably closer to plastic. I mean, it looks like leather. It kind of feels kind of like leather. It's not too big. It's not too small. It's like, it's just right. All right. So moving back a little bit, my tank push through bolt, that's basically the one of two bolts that holds your tank in place. All right, so moving back a little further on the tank, these are the tank cap covers. They're Harley-Davidson Motor Co. covers. They add just a little flavor to it. I used to have a big Harley-Davidson Motor Co. theme going on the bike, which I since kind of removed. So these are two of four last remaining pieces that I have. They look good. They go on with tape. It's not perfect. I'll be honest, it's not perfect, but it's good enough where I'm keeping it on the bike, at least for now. Moving further back, so my gauge cluster. Now, I did this last year in the modernization video where I added the new gauge cluster that also includes the tachometer. It's a little pricey, but it's really not that bad for what you get. It's great to have the tachometer now that's not just in digital form. Other than that, the rest of the tank is stock, except for the paint, which we'll get to. All right, so the seat is LaPera Bare Bones. It's not the most comfy seat, but it's definitely one of the best looking seats on the market that you can get for a Softail Deluxe. No rips, no nothing. The seat has been awesome, and yet it's one of the most touched things on the bike, yet it's held up so well. Horn cover is a chrome circular horn cover I got on eBay for like 30 bucks. It's been awesome. There really aren't that many options for horn covers. It's pretty weird because it's such a simple design. But this I thought was like just right, circular, chrome, it looks great, no problem.
I'm sorry, there's a mouse in the kitchen.
Oh, fuck. And we're back from the mouse situation. The crash bars. Also eBay, $90. I love the mustache kind of thing because it's got that low swoop instead of the other kind of swoop, which I think looks a little frumpy for these bikes. Pegs, pedals, and floorboards, all made by Cyclesmiths. I got their matching, the whole matching set. It's all made in America. It's quality stuff. I got it, I think, in January. This stuff, what a awesome look. It pops, but it doesn't pop too much. It's like just right. It's such a timeless look. They actually do custom stuff as well, which I didn't even know. I'm actually having some stuff done for the Road King, which we're gonna get to in a couple episodes coming up. There's a new strange godless demon awake inside me. There's a force divine terrorizing the air. Alright, so engine covers. Derby and timing are both by Vitti's. Derby I did black, timing I did brass. At the time, they didn't offer brass for the Derby, but I'm glad I did black because I didn't want it to be too much brass. They are engine covers, so, you know, there's not really that much that can go wrong, especially with the timing cover, which it's really covering nothing. It's like a fake cover. But they are great. They're heavy. They're substantial. They're very expensive, but it matches the rest of the Vitti's equipment. All right, so keeping with Vitti stuff, the air cleaner, or doesn't really clean any air because there's no filter on it. It's just a grating. I can't really say it really added much performance, but it looks so awesome, and that's really what Cholo is all about. I have noticed that if I'm wearing pants, and they're like thinner pants, and I really romp on it and my pant leg is right up against the intake, it'll actually start to suck my pants to the intake. All right, so I put a chrome cover on my rear brake fluid reservoir. It looks great, really not much to it. All right, and then I did engine bolt nut covers, also made by Colony. They're great, they were like $20, they're chrome, they cover the ugly nuts that get so beat up just from weather and age. Then I got an analog temperature gauge for my oil reservoir cap. Just be careful if you do look for those. I think there are two different sizes. And the first time I ordered the wrong size, it was a pain in the butt, but I got it right, and it's great. I actually use it all the time. I did braided white and black spark plug wires. These I thought were a great little addition to the bike. I think they're made by Taylor. I really can't remember because I had another set of white ones, but these are white with a little specks of black. They just look really dope with this bike because it's white and black. So then I did a lower belt guard, also chrome to get rid of that plastic black crappy one that they give you. This is chrome, it's made by Drag Specialties. Then my pulley, my drive pulley is by DNA. It's normal, I think it's 65 teeth. It's the, you know, it's stock size. I didn't go up or down any teeth. I'm using ARP stainless bolts. I'm using the replica beehive taillight from back in the 40s Harley used to use. So I wanted to do a slightly different design than my original paint was on my bike. So I found a painter out in Connecticut. I brought everything to him. I told him what I wanted. We went over everything. Couple months later, bam. Both fenders are made by Pickard USA down in Texas. They're made of fiberglass. I had them painted along with the tank. You know, both fenders, they're gonna run you about $1,000 unpainted. This is the stretched 140 mil French pocketed rear fender. And then the front is made for a 21 inch front wheel. You can get all different kinds of sizes. I have a 21 inch front wheel, so I got the 21 inch front fender. I think it looks awesome. All All right, so the wheels are made by DNA. 18 by 3.5, 21 by 3.5. I had the wheels and the hubs powder coated in black, and the spokes are done in chrome with the diamond design. This is my third set of DNAs. I haven't had any issues with any of them. They've been great. The prices are, you know, they're not cheap, but they're not crazy. As far as tires, I'm running the Avon Cobras. These are 120, 70, 21. These are 150, 70, 18. Now my engine fasteners are in brass. I got them from a company off eBay, which is based in Pennsylvania. I think the brass looks great on top of the chrome. It looks great on top of the black. I actually got the upper fork fasteners, which hold up your headlight system. I even got bolts from them with brass acorn nuts that hold your rear fender, which I actually just recently changed. I ended up going with gloss black bolts with brass flat washers. I think it's a cleaner look. It looks less steampunkish, if you want to call it that. I think it's a stupid word, but that's what a lot of people refer to it as. I think it looks more of like a tuxedo look, where it's just got the, you know, like black buttons on a white shirt. So that's what I ended up doing. I did the same thing for the upper fork fasteners. I think it really looks good, and you might see a little bit more coming up. I also did the engine head bolt covers in brass. I think they look awesome. I did brass acorn nuts and flat washers to hold my seat in place. I think it looks great. Just a nice little accent on top of the black. I also did brass axle nut covers. They really complete that brass look. My rear swing arm covers I actually got from Harley. They're the same ones kind of as my gas tank cap covers. That's a Harley-Davidson Motor Co. Very unnoticed on the left side, but the right side, you can see it. As far as the exhaust, the headers are by Samson, but the final runout is actually by Steady Custom Cycles. If you're looking for, you know, like a custom final piece or a different looking fishtail or just really, really long, check out my Steady Custom Cycles. This is my second pair from them, and they've been great. They sound great. They pair right up with the Samson headers, no problem. You just have to let them know which headers you have on them when you order them. That way they can make sure that they're gonna fit properly, and their prices aren't even that bad. All right, suspension. So the rear is shotgun shocks. Yeah. To all the killers and the $100 billers. I'm glad I went with them. I did the install myself. It was pretty easy. I even did a video on how to do it in case any of you want kind of just like a walkthrough. Sometimes it's nice to have. But they went on easy, they work great, not a single issue. You can do all kinds of things, and personally, I think compared to other air shock companies, you get more out of these for the money. Also, there's a lifetime warranty. Boom. The front suspension is actually the progressive monotubes, which can drop up to 2 inches. And then I did some crazy mod a couple years later where I dropped it an additional like 2/3 of an inch, which has been great. It does have a little bit more of a kickback, but the looks are just indisputable. So if you guys are doing a 2-inch drop, consider dropping it a little bit further to get that little bit of an edge on everybody else. And it drives me crazy when I see Cholo Softails with a squatted rear end and the high front. You got air suspension in the rear. You haven't even touched your front. You're squatting. Now you're changing the geometry of the bike. You're putting more weight in the rear. less weight in front, which means you have less sag, so the front end is even higher. Lower your front end. If you're honestly prioritizing comfort on one of these bikes, then good luck. That's all I can tell you. If you really want comfort, get a Road King. Don't get this. If you made it to this point, you made it to the end. Guys, thanks for watching. See you soon. Tonight.